Hello and welcome to Java tutorial. Today we'll be seeing about packages and inheritance. First, let us see about packages. Packages is a mechanism to encapsulate a group of classes, interfaces, and sub-packages. It is easy to organize class file into packages. We need to put related class files in the same directory, give the directory a name that relates to the purpose of the classes, and add a line to the top of each class file that declares a package name. There are two types of packages in Java, predefined packages and user-defined packages. Predefined packages are those that come along with the Java IDE, such as java.lang package, java.io package, java.util package, etc. In this tutorial, we'll be seeing about user-defined packages. Here we have created a package library, which has the classes borrow and return. Both of these classes are used within the class LMS. Here is the coding. In order to mention the class borrow as a part of the package library, we use the keyword package space package name. In this instance, it is package space library. We have also done this for the class return. In order to use these class files in the package, we import it by using the keyword import space package name. By using the dot star, we ensure that all the classes within the package library are imported into this class file. Let us run this program and see the output. That is all about classes, packages. Till now, next let us move on to inheritance. Inheritance provides relationship between classes. As you may have two classes, base and derived, we can provide relationship between the classes by using the keyword extends. We have multiple types of inheritance, such as single level inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, and hybrid inheritance. First, let us see about single inheritance. Single inheritance is which we have a single base class which is inherited by a single derived class. Let us see an example for this. We have a class A which has a method A. We have another class B which extends A, that is B inherits A. B also has its own class method B. In the main function, we have created an object for class B and used to call both the methods, method A and method B. Now let us run this program and see the output. That is about single level inheritance. Now let us see about multi-level inheritance. Multi-level inheritance is in which a base class. Multi-level inheritance in which a base class is inherited by another a derived class, which derived class also acts as a base class for other derived class. That is, inheritance occurs in multiple stages. Let us see a program to understand this concept. We have a class students, which is inherited by the class marks. This marks is also inherited by the class final total. As we can see, the first place class is students, which is inherited by marks. Currently, this class marks acts as a derived class. But now, in the case of class final total, which extends marks, marks becomes the base class for the class final total. Each has its own methods which are used within this, and have an object is created for the class final total and all the methods are called within this. Let us run this code and see the output. Next, let us see about hierarchical inheritance. Hierarchical inheritance is in which a class is inherited by multiple derived classes. That is, there is a single base class which can be inherited by two or more derived classes. Let us see an example for this. We have a class community member, which is inherited by the class employee as well as the class student. Now, the class employee itself acts as the base class for the class faculty as well as the class staff. There is another class, my class, which is used in order to recall all these methods. There is an object created for the employee class, for the student class, for the faculty class, and for the staff class. All the methods are called using the objects. Now let us run this code and see the output. Now let us see about hybrid inheritance. As the name itself says, hybrid inheritance is a hybrid of all other inheritance concepts such as multi-level and hierarchical inheritance. It involves both inheritance structures to create a new inheritance pattern. Let us see an example for this. Now we have a class A, which is inherited by the class B as well as the class C. This is an example for hierarchical inheritance. Now we have a class D which extends C, but since C is already inherits A, the functions of A also exists in D. That is, class A is a derived base class. Now class C is a derived class of class A, and class D is a derived class of class C. So this is an example for multi-level inheritance. An object is created for class D, which is used to call method D and method A. An object is also created for class B in order to call method B and method A, which exists within class B. Now let us run this program and see the output. As we can see, all the inheritance concepts are used in order to make sure there is a relationship between two or more classes. Thank you for listening to this video about packages inheritance.